a company which was started by 5 men who were working in a CA firm. They decided to quit their job and start their own broking firm. When all the brokerage houses, majority I can say, were operating out of Mumbai, they thought of starting their own from Hyderabad. A dream which was that we should have our broking firm in the top iconic brokerage houses of India is right now being questioned for malpractices. I hope you have understood which firm I'm talking about. Yes, indeed. I'm talking about Carvy fraud right now. Many of you had requested me that I should make a separate video on that. I had received all these requests in the comment section. So I thought of making a short video on exactly what happened, number one. We are also going to talk about how it happened. Number three, we are going to talk about what were the remedial actions which were taken by SEBI. And one more, what remedial actions, or I may say what precautions we as investors should take. So let's understand exactly how it happened. So for that, we have to understand the concept of taking a loan against share. So one is like having a margin to trade, or one is like taking loan against shares, right? So let's understand how this happens. Let's say we are talking about a person's demat account in which you already have shares. Okay, this is a demat account. This is an individual's demat account and in which you have shares. Now, like an individual has a demat account, a broker's demat account is known as a broker's account is known as a pool account. Okay, so pool account is essentially an account in which all the shares are first deposited and then are sold. Or if you are buying shares, first shares are taken into the pool account and then into your customer's account. Okay, if you have not understood what this is, I'll give you a simple example. Let us say this is Mr. Y, who has purchased shares from someone. Now what happens if Mr. Y has bought the shares? If he is the buyer, then of course there is some seller. Now let us say there is this seller from whom these shares have been bought. Do you think from his demat account the shares will directly jump into his account? Answer is no. The shares from this guy's demat account first go into the pool account and then from the pool account to the demat account. Okay till here? So that's how the shares travel from one person's demat account to other person's demat account. So going back to our discussion, what happens is that, assume that this guy wants to take a margin or wants to have a loan against his shares. So what happens? This broker transfers some of the shares from his account. Okay, these shares are transferred from his account to the pool account. Now these shares are transferred to a bank's account. So basically, why bank is coming into picture? Because this guy wants a loan. Okay, so what is happening is that against this loan, against these shares, a charge is being created. Okay, so what do we mean by charge? These shares are offered as a security. Okay, who is giving security? These shares are being transferred from demat account to pool account. Yahan pe aa gaye wo. And from here, a charge is created, a lien is created on these shares. Now, what does the bank do? Now, bank in return is going to give loan, which is then going to be passed on to this individual. Of course, there's going to be some margin here. So let's say bank gives loan at the rate of 12%. This broker is going to offer it at 18%. Beech ka jo 6% hai, this 6% gap is like the profit for the broker. Okay, this is what a very routine case happens. Okay, now the question is that when shares are to be transferred from the demat account to the pool account, can the broker take it just like that? No. Here a document comes into picture, and this document is known as a power of attorney. Okay, I have made a separate video on power of attorney. Don't jump from this video directly to that video, otherwise you won't come back again. So first watch this entire video, then watch this. I'll put the I button for this POA at the end of the video, right? So power of attorney is nothing but me as an individual, I give permission to my broker to take out shares from my demat account and to transfer it somewhere else. Okay, I remember when I used to trade in 2006, 7, 8, whatever, early days, there used to be a delivery instruction slip, okay, DIS. Even today, delivery instruction slip is there. Okay, many brokers use that. In what we have to, what is that? Physically, we have to sign the delivery instruction slip. We have to give it to the broker. And then only broker can take out the shares from my demat account and take it into the pool account. But then it's a very tiresome process. Every time, every single security you are selling off, you have to sign off the POA. You have to sign off the delivery instruction slip. So to cancel out this delivery instruction slip, what brokers do is that they take a power of attorney. In simple words, we give the power, we give the authority to the broker that you can take out shares from my demat account. Now, is this risky? It may be risky if the broker is not honest. Okay. Does everyone sign off a POA? Of course, yes. I'm sure you have signed up POA while opening your account. You remember that day when you opened the demat account where you might have signed at least 50 pages, 50 different signs. At the end, you only start getting a feeling that maybe my sign on the first page and my sign on the last page does not match. Itne jab signs kiye honge na? During that process, there is one sign when you sign on the POA, power of attorney, wherein you give this right to the broker. Now, is there any solution? Can I avoid giving this POA? Yes. How is that done? We are going to talk at the end of this video. So, I hope this basic process of a margin or loan against shares is understood. This is ideally what happens. Yahan pe problem hai hi nahi, toh where is the problem? Now, what happened? Now, Karvi, what they did was, Karvi tried to find out certain accounts which are like dormant accounts. Okay, I hope you understand dormant accounts. Dormant accounts is like accounts in which there is no real activity as such. 5 saal, 5 years, 6 years. There is no trade which has happened. So that's like a dormant account. Now what this broker did was that from such dormant accounts, they found out such dormant accounts, they transferred the shares to the pool account. Okay, how? Because they already had a POA. From this pool account, they transferred it to the bank. Basically, they took a charge. They had a charge on these shares. They took a lien on these shares, and against which they again took a loan from the bank. Now, where was this loan forwarded? Because this guy does not need the loan right now. This is a dormant account. Now, this loan was given to the subsidiaries, okay? Subsidiaries of Karvi, which was mainly into realty business, okay? So, this is what was done without the permission of the shareholders. I hope you have understood how this entire thing operated. Okay, if you have not, just maybe revise it one more time and then go on to the next section of this video. This was how the fraud could have been done in the first manner. Now, second thing what happens, let us understand. Okay, routine scenario is that ideally, there's this DMAT account of the individual. This is the broker's pool account. Okay. Now, as I told you, let us say there is a seller here. Seller sells the shares. We are the buyer. And as I mentioned, the seller is going to sell his shares. First, the shares are going to come to the broker's pool account. And from here, they are going to go to the DMAT account. What could be a possibility? This fellow does not pay money. Okay. Now, what does the broker say? If this guy has not paid the money, why should I transfer the shares to the DMAT account? So, I don't transfer it. Now, here, if they have not transferred it to the DMAT account, anyways, it's there with the broker. Now, what broker did? Again, same old story. Here is the bank. These shares were again pledged with the bank. Charge was created, lien was created, loan was taken and disbursed to the subsidiary. Okay. Now, SEBI said, there is a circular which is issued by SEBI. SEBI says that if this guy has not paid the money, if your individual buyer has not paid you money, you should ideally transfer these shares. You should ideally transfer these shares to a different account. This is what SEBI says. You should transfer it to a different account. This is known as the unpaid account, unpaid shares account or unpaid account. And if it is transferred to the unpaid account, then the broker does not get the opportunity to take loan against any shares which are lying in the unpaid account. And that is what the broker did. Broker, instead of transferring this to the unpaid account, they kept it with themselves and they took a lien. They took a lien against these shares, they created a charge against these shares and borrowed loan. Okay, so in simple words, what happened? Is this a fraud of POA? Does a POA come into picture here? No. That's the difference between fraud number one and fraud number two. Here it is done through POA. This fraud was done through POA. And fraud number two, which I'm talking about, here POA is not yet involved because the shares never entered the DMAT account. This was done before the shares even entered the DMAT account of the individual. I hope both these frauds are absolutely clear now. In the next section, we are going to talk about what is the remedial action that we should take and or what should be the precaution that we should take and what SEBI has done on this. What had happened was, as I mentioned, that a loan was taken against these shares. Almost shares worth rupees 1,000 crores were pledged with various financial institutions, including banks like ICICI Bank, HDFC Bank, IndusInd, Bajaj Finance. From all these, the loan was taken. Now, SEBI said that it is not at all the fault of these investors. You should return all these shares which were pledged. They should be returned to the investors. So what NSDL and CDSL, these are the two leading depositories in India. Okay, so these two depositories, they, with the help of SEBI circular, they transferred almost 90% of such pledged securities back from the institutions, financial institutions, and they have given it back to the shareholders. Still 10% of the securities are lying with the bank. Bank is saying, what is our fault? We have given a loan. We had to take a security, and that's what we have done. We are not at fault. But SEBI says that banks, you are also aware about the circular. Circular which said that the unpaid securities should have been kept in a separate account, and against these securities, no pledging was allowed. So SEBI is of the opinion that maybe banks are also somewhere at fault, but still this is going on. I can't blame anyone directly. So still a big question mark, but I hope you have understood what is the point. That majority of the shares, 90% of the shares are back with the investors, but still the problem is that 10% is still remaining, and there's a still dispute going on within SEBI, the broker, and these banks. Okay, now what can be done is, I feel a very nice solution to this is that, as I mentioned, you should check your statement very, very, very oftenly. Least thing that you can do is once a month. Okay. Now, if you have multiple DMAT accounts, you know, there are many people who love to open more and more DMAT accounts. There is some offer going on, open an account, Flipkart voucher, open an account. Okay. So if you have done this, then the headache is that I have 4 DMAT accounts, 5 DMAT accounts. Should I go on checking each and every DMAT account every month? No, there's a simpler way. All your DMAT accounts are linked with a depository. Okay. Either it would be CDSL or NSDL, either of the two. So I'm going to tell you a very simple way on how you can actually get yourself registered. Okay, even if you don't know the exact link, I'll just show you how to register with CDSL. Okay, or if it is NSDL, you can just click on NSDL as well. Okay, here you can see there's a help for registration and password. So what I do is online registration. Now, what does this say? I'll read it out for you. So what you have to do is log on to this website, cdslindia.com. Okay, so here we are. Where are we? Okay, cdslindia.com. Now here I'm saying log on to this. Now it's very easy. What you have to do is you just have to have your username, password. If you have not yet registered, then you have to just click here. This is the simple way of registering with CDSL. Here you have to enter your DMAT account number. Okay, any of your statement which your broker might have given to you that contains the 16-digit DMAT account. So enter this 16-digit DMAT account here. Enter the password. Your password is your PAN plus DDMM, date of birth. Just check this, I'm not a robot. Then click register, terms and conditions, check mark. And if you press yes, that's where you have registered. That's the last point. Enter your details, login ID, email ID, etc. Your password, PAN, everything I told. And once you're registered, the best part is that you get all your DMAT account holdings in one statement. Because please understand, it's like DMAT 1, DMAT 2, DMAT 3 with different brokers all get clubbed up under one statement of CDSL. So life becomes very easy, very sorted. So I request everyone should register themselves with CDSL, NSDL. This is a video which is not sponsored by any of these depositories. This is for your benefit. Get yourself registered and have ease of access to all your holdings. So as I mentioned, you'll find the I button for the POA video, power of attorney video, which I had done some months ago. You can check that. Second thing is that if you want to support my channel and if you want to start trading also, if you want to start investing, you can open an account with either Upstox or with Zerodha. There are many, many brokers as well, but these are the two leading brokers as far as the discount broker segment is concerned. Right now, Upstox also has a very good scheme whereby, number one, you can open a free account with Upstox. Number two, you get Flipkart vouchers worth rupees 500. This 500 is split off as 300 plus 200. 300 rupees you will get when you open the account, and you will get an additional voucher of 200, which you will get when you do your first trade within 7 days of the account opening, right? Very, very, very important point is that you have to use the promo code UPSTOCKS500. It's there in the description box also, but the promo code is UPSTOCKS500. This will be applicable, this 500 rupees thing will be applicable if you open your account before 31st of December. Very important. These Flipkart vouchers will reach your email box by the 20th of January. Guys, please be aware that it is not my responsibility to issue these vouchers. It's going to come from Upstox. So just in case there's a delay of 1 or 2 days, please don't write emails to me. Write emails to Upstox and get your voucher. You have the link in the description box wherein you get all the account opening link and everything. One more broker, as I mentioned, Zerodha is also a very good broker. They also have this power of attorney thing, like with the e-power of attorney. Upstox, Zerodha, both have this concept of e power of attorney. That is, every single trade you initiate, there's a separate power of attorney which will be generated. And you just have to either send your power of attorney through an OTP, or what you can do is for Zerodha, I guess, they have a checkbox which you just have to check and then proceed with your trade. That's it from my side. I hope you have liked this video. If you like this, consider subscribing to my channel. If you feel, you can send this video link to your friends as well. That's it from my side. Jai Hind. Bye-bye.